Hello guys, in this video I am going to discuss block diagram of microcontroller AT89S52. This is the detailed block diagram of AT89S52. This is there in data sheet of this microcontroller. And this is the simplified block diagram of that microcontroller. Let me go through one by one. First is CPU. CPU is nothing but processor. This CPU resides inside the microcontroller. It is the heart of the embedded systems. CPU is used to perform arithmetic and logical operations. It fetches program instructions from memory and executes instructions one by one. That means the program is resided in flash or raw memory. It fetches the instructions and executes. The instructions are assembly language instructions. We are writing program in embedded C that can be converted into a assembly during compilation stage. There are different CPUs like single core, dual core, tri-core and multi-core. So our 8051 microcontroller is a single core microcontroller. That means there is only one CPU inside. To execute instructions, the CPU requires clock frequency. Some instructions take one clock cycle to execute, and few instructions may take more than one clock cycle to execute instructions. The clock frequency to the microcontroller may be internal to the microcontroller or external to the microcontroller. In this 8051 microcontroller, there is no internal oscillator circuit. So we need to give externally. The speed of the microcontroller decides the clock frequency of the microcontroller. If we give more frequency, then the microcontroller will be faster. If we give less frequency, then the microcontroller will be slower. In this microcontroller, maximum we can give 33 MHz as given in the data sheet. The clock controls the time for executing an instruction. After the power supply, the clock is the basic requirement of any embedded system. Many other internal peripherals depends on this clock frequency, like ADC, timers, PWM, communication protocols, etc. It's very critical, essential for microcontroller. The oscillator circuit should be very stable. That is the reason mostly we use crystal oscillator circuit for microcontroller clock. Crystal oscillator provides very stable clock. It is made up of one crystal and two capacitors as shown here. Coming to memories, There are various types of memories like RAM, ROM, flash in a microcontroller. So we'll go one by one. So what is a RAM memory? So in this microcontroller we have 256 bytes of RAM. So what is a RAM? RAM is a temporary data. That means whenever the power is off, then the memory will be cleared. It is also called as volatile memory. RAM stores the variables during the program execution and storing the stack. The RAM layout contains code, data, heap and stack blocks. I will make a separate video to discuss this RAM layout, that is code, data, heap, stack. There are different types of RAM memories, that is like dynamic RAM, static RAM, etc. Next is ROM or flash memory. It is used to store application programs, that is X file, where the CPU fetches the instruction codes. Few microcontrollers having ROM, not flash, to store X file, and most of the microcontrollers having flash memory to store the X file. In this 8089S52, we don't have ROM memory, we have only flash memory. Both are used to store X file. I will discuss difference between ROM, EEPROM, flash in a separate video. In 8089S52, we have 8 KB of flash memory. That means our written program should not cross this 8 KB. Next is I/O ports. I/O port means input-output ports. I/O ports used to interface different input and output device to the microcontroller externally. There are 4 ports in 8051 family microcontrollers, that is port 0, port 1, port 2, port 3. Each port having 8 pins. So total we have 32 I/O pins, that is GPIO pins. Next is timers or counters. For timers or counters, these two are combined in a single block. Timers are used to generate delays. So that means we can set time for an application. For example, if you want to blink an LED in every 1 second, we need delay here to meet exact 1 second delay. So we need to use timers. Counters are used to count external events. We will discuss timers or counters in detail during timers programming. Next is serial or UART port. It is used to transmit or receive data serially. There is only one UART port in 8089S52 microcontroller. It requires 2 pins, that is transmit data, receive data. It is used to interface different external modules like GSM module, GPS module, RFID module, etc. It's also used to communicate in between two microcontrollers or microcontroller to computer. We will discuss in detail during your programming. Next is bus control. It is used to control data flow in between internal peripherals. There are different buses like data bus, address bus, and control bus. And the last is interrupt control. In embedded systems, we use many sensors, serial communication, and different external modules to interface microcontroller. These external devices communicate through I/O ports. In order to get information from these microcontroller, uses two methods, that is polling or interrupt. That means in order to get information from these microcontroller uses two methods, that is polling or interrupt. In polling method, the microcontroller continuously checking the status of devices. For example, we have simple microcontroller circuit with one switch and LED. The application is whenever we press the switch, then the LED should glow. In polling method program, the processor always check the status of the switch and decide the LED condition. In this polling method, it consumes more CPU time, so the CPU execution time is wasted. Whereas in interrupt programming method, whenever the switch is pressed, then only it executes the operation without checking the switch state continuously. So the CPU time can be saved. So interrupt is a very important feature in microcontroller. It is basically an event or request that require immediate attention of microcontroller. When the interrupt occurs, depends on the interrupt priority, the microcontroller serves the event. There are limited interrupts in a microcontroller. That is, there are different interrupts as given in the data sheet. So we have two external interrupts, that is INT0, INT1. And three timers, timer interrupts, timer 0, timer 1, timer 2, and one serial interrupt. Reset also an interrupt which has the highest priority. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned.